again, my friend. I'm sure you're eager to hear what we've discovered since the last time you were on Elam.
To be honest, it's not looking promising.
How so?
There wasn't a whole lot to find that wasn't completely demolished.
The team here has carefully studied everything that survived Malgus's attack, but we haven't identified the purpose of the device inside the fortress ruins.
Have you at least narrowed it down?
The machine was capable of several functions: data projection, long-range communication, power generation. But we still don't fully understand how Darth Nall actually used the machine, or why. My hope is that you could provide some wisdom, give us a perspective we hadn't considered yet. Especially since you and Tau saw so much of this area before Malgus attacked.
This is...
Kira?
It all makes sense. This feeling I have, why it's so strong. This is from Darth Nall's machine. The one Malgus blew up?
We think so, yeah.
Nall. She was one of us. A child of the Emperor.
You were a child of the Emperor?
Don't get the wrong idea. I gave everything I had to break that connection. It almost killed me.
Children of the Emperor? The ones possessed by the old Sith Emperor? Aren't they all gone?
It's complicated. The children have been around for centuries, like the servants, the ones we stopped from killing Master Satil. But unlike the servants, we weren't eager recruits. The Sith took people and implanted them with a small piece of the old Emperor's power. The things he could make us do. And we didn't even know what was going on when he did it. Well, most of us didn't.
But the Emperor is gone. If he had any control left over the remaining children, that connection has been severed.
So why is Malgus so interested in one of the old Emperor's puppets? One who hasn't been around for centuries?
There may be someone who could tell us. Sahar Katim.
Who is that?
She was the Padawan of Master Denom Orr, the leader of the expedition team that Malgus attacked.
Sahar and Master Orr lived on our colony on Ossus. They were good friends.
We've scoured every corner of these ruins. Everyone Master Orr brought to Elam has been accounted for, except Sahar.
If she's not here, we should find out where she is. She needs protection.
I hope Sahar's okay, wherever she is.
Hey, don't worry. We'll find her.
Our next priority will be identifying anything that could lead us to Sahar. In the meantime, you should go straight to the source for more information. Speak to Malgus.
You think he'll say anything?
From what I understand, Malgus has unwavering confidence in his plans, despite his capture.
And if he thinks destiny is on his side, who knows what he'll say?
Let us hope he offers something useful. I fear that our work has only just begun.
Rakan? It's me. It's Sahar. Wait. Rakan! Please! Stop! What is wrong with you? I risked everything to be here and you won't even listen to me! If I hadn't saved you, who knows what these slavers would have...
What in blazes are you talking about? I'm not a slave.
But I thought...
You left. You don't know anything. This should have been my fight. My chance at greatness. But you stole it from me. Again.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, Rakan. For everything. I shouldn't have spoken to you like that, and I'm sorry for leaving you behind. I regret it. All the time. I would give anything to go back and do things differently. I know I can never completely make it up to you, but please, can I at least try? Whatever you need, I can help you.
I don't need you. But I do know someone who can use you. Follow me. Keep up and keep quiet, or you're finished.